Hey guys, it's the Villaman here, and I have the new SVS SB3000 and PB3000 subwoofers in for review. And during that time, I wanted to do a few demo videos for you guys to help you understand how these subwoofers really perform. So, stick around. So in this video, I'll be doing a demo of the PB3000, and now since it's a ported subwoofer, it can be operated in extended and in sealed mode. In extended, it has a frequency response of 16 Hz to 270 Hz, while in sealed mode, it has a response of 18 Hz to 270 Hz. So ported is better for home theater applications like movies, while sealed is better for music. So in this movie demo, I'll be testing its home theater performance in both modes. So this demo will be largely based on the comments I received from the unboxing video. And a bunch of people also gave me a bunch of scenes they wanted to see, so I'll be incorporating those. So in a future video, I'll also be comparing how the PB3000 compares to the SB4000. Now these are both similarly priced. The SB4000 is $1,500 while the PB3000 is $1,400. And even though the PB3000 has a larger cabinet, their size aren't that different either. So if you like tech and home theater, then you've come to the right place because this is your destination for unboxings, reviews, and demos. So hit that subscribe button and come along for the ride. Alright, so now that all of that business has been taken care of, let's get into it.
Here we go.
Sure, if we're even on the air, this is a series of explosions.
First of the egg!
seeing this?
Yeah, I see it. That's Kaneda's bike from Akira. Some license skin over standard frame.
No, not the bike. Forget the bike. The girl. I think it's Artemis.
The Artemis? The Sixer Fixer?
I've seen all her walkthroughs, her Twitch streams. It's her. It's definitely her.
Thank you.
All right, so that was the demo. The PB3000 has a ridiculous amount of output, like seriously. I had the trim in the receiver set to about -6.5 and the sub itself set to -20 dB, and you could hear the rattling of the things on the wall. So all my frames and pictures I had just kept rattling. I may need some double stick tape or something for them. So because this was a test of the subwoofer, I had all my speakers crossed over at 80 Hz. For anyone interested, I'll leave links to all my equipment in the description below. Now, I mentioned the comparison of the PB3000 and the SB4000 I'll be doing in the future, but I can tell you one thing off the bat, that the PB3000 has more output. It does. But it also has a lot less power, so that might not entirely be a good thing, because power is how the subwoofer maintains control, especially at higher volume, so we'll have to see how well that translates. It's actually interesting, the PB3000 was able to reproduce so much more low-end frequency at a lower setting than the SB4000, so I think a direct comparison between these two would be very interesting. Let me know in the comments if you want to see that. Now, I tested the steel performance of the sub using the intro to Edge of Tomorrow, and it was as I expected. It had less output and it didn't feel as visceral as it did before. But the next demo I'll be doing with the sub is with music using both modes, so stay tuned for that. I hope you're subscribed. And don't forget to like the video if you liked the video and found it helpful. Until next time, this has been your friendly neighborhood Villaman saying, peace.